Guys, can I share my heart with you? I'm sitting in the car. It's rainy outside, but it's also rainy inside my heart right now. I almost feel depressed. The last 4 weeks, I have 4 cases of people where I've just seen sexual sin. I've seen very bad decisions where it often excuses like God spoke to me or the Holy Spirit said. And I'm almost in a place now where next time I hear somebody said, oh, the Holy Spirit said, I was like, please don't say that. I don't care what the Spirit said to you. What do the words say? Because if it's truly the Holy Spirit, it will not go against His word. It's so easy to say, oh, the Spirit said, or the Holy Spirit said, or the Holy Spirit spoke to us. The Holy Spirit will never go against His word. I believe in hearing from the Holy Spirit. Trust me, I believe in being led by the Holy Spirit. You who know me and know my testimony, I believe in that. But I just see it taking gold total from one ditch to the other. There's people out here who never listen to the Spirit and so on, but there is a whole movement today where there is no fear of God. We talk about, yeah, but God, He's my Father. Yeah, He's your Father. And the Spirit's crying out, Abba, Father. But God is also a consuming fire. If God is not a consuming fire in your life and you don't fear God, then it's the wrong God you are worshiping. Even the Spirit say, Abba, Father, He's still a consuming fire, still today in the New Testament. And the lack of the fear of God and the whole thing of listening to the Spirit, I just seen it so unhealthy and it frustrates me. Yeah, but I'm healing the sick, I'm casting out demons, I'm going out on the street and baptizing people, water, Holy Spirit, God is with me. Do you know what? That is not a sign in itself that God is with you. Just want to say that is not a sign that you are healing and saying cast out demons, speaking tongues. Sorry, that is not a sign. That is not a sign. Read the word Matthew 7. Not everyone who say Lord, Lord to me will enter into the kingdom of God, but the one who do the will of my Father who's in heaven. And the will of the Father who's in heaven, yes, we have to heal the sick, we have to preach the gospel, we have to do that. But there's so much more. Jesus was the He called the name Jesus because He's to save us from our sins. We need holiness. We need to live according to His word. One day many will say, Lord, Lord, have I not prophesied in your name? Have I not cast out demons in your name? Done many wonders in your name? And I will declare to them, I never knew you. Depart from me, you workers of lawlessness. I never knew you. That is the intimate fellowship, walking by the Spirit, knowing Christ. And one of the things the Holy Spirit is doing is changing, transforming our life, making us holy. One day we should shout, holy, 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 our Father who's in heaven. Holy, 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 He is holy. I never knew you. Maybe you have a kind of relationship, but you never really know Him in an intimate, strong way. It's not enough to prophesy, it's not enough to cast out demons, it's not enough to heal the sick. If you live a lawless life, I don't care about all the other things. And God don't care. He will not let you come into the kingdom of God because you heal the sick and cast out demons. If you break His law. And I've just seen so much, like God spoke to me, the Holy Spirit spoke to me. God said I should divorce that man. God said I should marry that man, marry that woman. God said I should stop my job and just leave and don't pay my bills. No, God will not say that if they go against His word. If you have some bills, pay your bills. Or the Holy Spirit said I should move there and do this. And it had become an excuse for submission to healthy leadership. It had been an excuse of submission to the word of God that the Holy Spirit said, God said. And I'm not against listening to the Holy Spirit. Some of you know my testimony, how I met my wife. And if you don't know, I will share short here. When I gave my life to Christ, I was living in an unhealthy relationship with my girlfriend. The Holy Spirit came. I cut it off with her. Why? Because when you're born again, you cannot continue in sin. I said, God, next time I'm going to be with one, it's going to be my wife. Help me, who's going to be my wife? And then I was at a concert and God spoke to me. I heard God say, Torben, the one who's standing behind you is going to be your wife someday. I turned around, seven rows behind me in a room with 500 people. I saw that girl. Whoa. And I knew that was going to be my wife. God spoke to me. I only smiled to her, jumped in a car, went home. I said to my friend on the way home, hey, Michael, I've just met my wife. I don't know her name. I don't know where she's from. I don't know how old she is. I don't know anything about her. But God has said that girl in that dress is one day going to be my wife. I came home. I said, God, I thank you for the girl in the yellow dress. You had to put us together. She's one day going to be my wife. 3 months later, God put us together. And a year later, we were married. And we have been married 23 years now. And we had 3 kids and 2 grandkids. And we have lived holy since that. And we was not go to bed with each other and all of that before we were married. And it was a beautiful, beautiful testimony. And we are married to death do us part because we have entered into a covenant. So simple. God spoke, I believe in God speaking. But I now have thousands of people say, oh, God spoke about this, God spoke about that, where it become manipulation. Some years ago, I had a friend where a girl heard, oh, you should marry like that. A girl heard that he should marry her. And he feared God, so he was afraid to go against it. And it became manipulation. Oh, God have said you should marry me. And he got confused. But he did not listen to that. Thank God for that. And now he's married to the right woman, another woman. And it's so easy to hear from God. I don't trust God speaks to us. I even don't trust God speak to me. I don't trust I can concern the voice I'm hearing if we go against this. Because yes, God spoke to me that she should be my wife. And I know it's God because it happened and it was according to this. But many don't know another story. Some years later, I was on a big, big attack. And suddenly I heard a voice say, leave your wife, leave your kids, go out in the world. And I heard the same voice. It was so clear as the other time. But this time I took the word of God. Go away, your says, and go away. Leave me in the name of Jesus. Leave me in the name of Jesus. But for 3 days, I heard a voice in my head. Leave your wife, leave your kids, and go out in the world. Why did I know it was not from God? Was it because how the voice, what the voice was saying? No. How the voice sound? No. Because it sound the same as the voice I heard when God said, who was going to be my wife? How did I know it was not from God? The reason? Because God will never go against his word. He will never go against his word. So I took the word and said, go away, Satan, leave me, Satan, leave me, Satan, leave me, Satan. After 3 days, suddenly that voice left me. And I was like, how could this happen? I love Jesus. I'm born again. I'm on fire. How can I hear another voice like this? A few days later, I got a prophecy that many have come to where I was but have fallen. And when I heard that the prophecy, I knew, whoa, now I understand. Sometimes we are being tested. Satan, he's a liar. He tested Jesus just after he received the Holy Spirit in the desert. But he knew that voice was not from God. Why? And because it went against the word of God. And he quoted the word of God every time against that voice in the desert and Satan left him. The same Satan, he tried to tempt me that time. Leave your wife, leave your kids. And I know it's what not from God. It was Satan who tried to tempt me. Why did I know it's not from God? Because it went against the word of God. Just because you hear a voice don't mean it's from God. That voice could be from Satan, like I heard it that time and like Jesus heard it in the desert. How do you test it? By the word and by the word alone. If it go against this word, it is not from God, no matter that you hear something. And we need to be better to test what we are hearing. Just because you hear a voice don't mean it's from God. It can be from Satan who tried to destroy your life, destroy your ministry. I've heard so many people, oh, God spoke to me to leave my wife. Or God has spoke to me to leave this and leave my job even. Check it. Maybe God have said leave your job. But maybe God is saying stay there. Be faithful in the small things. Submit to healthy counseling and leadership and submission. And grow and build character in your life. This is what I want to share. God bless you. See the pioneer school. Have a healthy respect for the word of God. Don't be deceived. Fear God. God bless you. Bye-bye.